Hi, I'm Takuya Hirano, and I lead the Global System Integrator and Advisory Partner business here at Microsoft. Today, I'm thrilled to speak with Jenny Kohler, U.S. Deputy Advisory Leader and U.S. Advisory Industrial Products and Services Vertical Leader at PwC. I'd like to have a conversation about the work we are doing to help customers develop their cloud strategy and drive business transformation. Welcome, Jenny.
Hi, Takuya. Thanks for having me.
Now, PwC and Microsoft have worked together to deliver a solution to customers for many years. Today, digital technology and the cloud play a critical role enabling business resilience and transformation. Now, what impact is the cloud having on how we work together and on what we are enabling for customers?
Well, I mean, it's a timely question, no doubt, and we do enjoy a very strong alliance across both PwC and Microsoft. And I would say this, the trends in cloud and the rate at which they're happening have really helped evolve and amplified, I think, our working relationship as more clients are looking to the cloud, specifically Azure, to transform how they do their work. On a personal note for us, the cloud, the journey to it, presents a great opportunity for us to double down on what we consider to be one of our core strengths, which is an industry lens to transformation, and to help our clients develop solutions to meet their needs in a way they frankly couldn't have before. So the power of Azure, plus the simplicity of the apps that go along with it, it presents great opportunity to accelerate a lot of progress and change for our clients. So we couldn't be more excited about it.
Now, to what extent do you see customers changing how they allocate resources and invest in digital transformation to drive revenue growth?
When we pulsed CFOs, 56% of them have said that technology investments will make their businesses better in the long run. And in our latest survey at the very end of calendar 2020, 76% of business executives surveyed said that they're going to allocate more resources to digital in 2021, as well as increases in cyber risk management to go along with that. So if we think about, I think, the why behind this amplification of digital investment, I think it truly is the holistic promise of how our clients conduct business, changing portfolios and operating models, increased resiliency in operations and in their cost, more intimacy with customers. I think you put all of that together, and I think business will be conducted differently, and there's no way to enable it without a digital investment writ large. Now, all of this, of course, puts the imperative out there for a platform to make it happen. And Microsoft, of course, brings that holistic stack of technologies in order to solve those end-to-end worker and operational issues.
No, I agree, Jenny. And then I think this is a critical and also pivotal moment for business. Now, with a new administration, availability of COVID-19 vaccine, and also struggling economy. And so what advice do you have for the customers who want to leverage cloud as part of their return to the office strategy?
I think we believe it's fair to assume at a minimum that we're gonna see hybrid working models emerge. And even in some cases, some job types completely being able to work remotely. And in the face of that, technology to enable it is critical. And that requires an overall upskilling of the workforce and the technology to support it. I would be remiss if I did not mention that underpinning all of this is of course the hope and the promise of what the vaccine will offer us in terms of the short run to return to something that resembles the normal of years past. And to that end, as you well know, we've been working with Microsoft in a number of countries to help with vaccine management and distribution. And so very hopeful indeed for the future.
We have talked a lot about how the cloud is enabling business transformation and the work we are doing to build industry platforms and solutions to help customers. So do you have thoughts on the industry that can benefit the most from cloud technology?
I think the reality is I can't think of an industry that would not benefit from migrating to the cloud. And all of the trends that I mentioned earlier are ubiquitous in terms of their presence. Now, of course, how they manifest themselves in each industry, the most powerful use cases, all become in different kind of focus, I think, depending upon the industry. But no matter the benefits that a digital undertaking will deliver, underpinning all of it, regardless of industry, is the need to do it securely, to protect data, and to bring an organization increased agility. And I think together with all of you, we are making great strides in changing the face of business and operations in many industries, just to name a few: health, financial services, consumer markets, manufacturing. I could go on, I think.
Yeah, no, I agree with you. But on that point, can you tell us about any of those solutions and what they make possible?
Yeah, I'll hit on one, not to make it too personal to the world that I get a chance to work with closely in manufacturing, but I'll touch briefly on our smart factory solution. As you know, we've been working with Microsoft in designing and implementing digital solutions that literally change the nature of work on a factory floor. Increased worker efficiency, decreased production and inventory costs, improving quality, et cetera. And we're establishing real-time data pipelines to an Azure-based platform with workflows and visualizations and a bunch of apps on it to make it all happen. Without a doubt, some great success to date. I look forward to seeing what is to come, not only in Smart Factory, but certainly in other industries as well.
Yeah, I lived in Japan for a long time. Manufacturing is a big thing over there, so a little biased too, but I'm also excited to see how the factory intelligence solution is realizing the business transformation. I mean, it's really exciting. Now, can you talk about the top business concerns you see customers trying to address with their investment in cloud technology?
First of all, trust and security with respect to anything in the cloud, particularly in regulated industries, continues to be a topic of conversation. I think nearly all of our clients are trying to really nail down the return on investment and the kind of business case that'll make a difference for them. The reality is, I think in some cases, there's been perceived large technical investments in years past that have been daunting or maybe haven't delivered on the promise. And I do believe that the cloud can deliver incremental value even faster to make that ROI more compelling. So I think that's a topic of conversation in any C-suite is getting that return. And then lastly, I think there's this dawning awareness of what it does to the workforce. The kinds of change we're talking about, the kind of agility you inject into a workforce, this fundamentally gets to how people do their jobs. And that's not to be taken lightly in terms of ensuring that workers truly have the right skills and capabilities to succeed. And that's, as you well know, a particular area we're very proud to team with Microsoft on addressing.
Yeah, and then when you think about the cloud strategy, you know, it's important not only think about today, but also future too. And as a customer plan their cloud strategy migration, what can they do to future-proof their cloud migration so they can easily add new capacities, services in the future, so on and so forth? So what do they need to think about?
Well, I think first it starts clearly with the objectives for the program itself, a clear, transparent business case up front, and a mindset towards delivery of incremental value along the way, not waiting until the very end of the journey to see those benefits. Along with that, I would say really thinking hard about the overall integrated architecture that supports it to prepare for not only the initial but future cloud adoption. I think understanding how that will play itself out over many, many, many years is very important. Governance model to support that, flexibility, in that architecture and in the business case, et cetera. And then I would say you've got to think about beyond that migration. This is a fundamental change to the way of working. So how do you continue to monitor and manage the data specific elements to that, scale it over time and size it? So, and then of course, I'll come back to what I've said quite a bit here, which is the humans involved in it, is have a plan for the upskilling of them and how you handle that change.
Yeah, I think empowering people and the people-centric notion, I really like that. And then you covered really great points and good advice for customers too, so thank you. Now, finally, what is the best way for customers who are interested in developing their cloud strategy to engage and work with PwC?
I appreciate the question, thank you for it. I'd say, first of all, essential to our ethos as one of the consultancies trying to help our clients address their cloud imperatives is we are, number one, a firm believer without a doubt that cloud will change how business is conducted. We've done it to ourselves, moving to cloud platforms. So within the four walls of PwC, we well understood what that means. And our mission now with our clients is to drive that step change in our clients' businesses and to approach that with very much a business first, industry led mindset. So simply put, we've not delivered value if we have not driven an incremental change in a client's business that we can measure. And if we've not changed the experience for workers and end users, then we will have failed. And in short, this is a big bet that we're determined to help businesses get right. To underscore how important we think that this is to our future in working with our clients, we've recently reorganized internally part of our business into a dedicated cloud hub, and that provides us the ability to scale, create the sense of community that we feel is critical for our professionals to grow their careers over time, and a great team of professionals that we want to have a rewarding experience in changing how our clients conduct their business.
I mean, clearly PwC is a great partner. I mean, they can help customers across industries and understanding the importance of the cloud and the value of the business transformation. I mean, you have so much experience and knowledge and elements. And PwC, you know how to build and implement cloud strategy and will help realize the customer's new business growth too. So, I mean, it's really, really exciting. So anyways, Jenny, it's been great talking to you. I'm excited about the solution we are building together for the customers and the partnership ahead of us. So thank you.
No, likewise, feel the same way. Thank you.